It's amazing to me that I have to spend 3 entire episodes teaching you people how to watch a couple of shows. Like, watching shows should be second nature. You show up and you watch it, then you leave. But for some reason, it's just not that simple because theme parks don't make it simple. If it was that simple, I wouldn't be here simplifying it for you. I'd probably be at the beach reading a book. Or maybe I'd be a scientist sending people to Mars. But no, I'm here, and together we're gonna learn the final key to mastering the art of watching Fantasmic and World of Color, Disneyland Edition. Roll the intro. Okay, so in a very quick recap, the moment you show up at the park, Disneyland, or California Adventure, depending on what show you want to watch, you make sure you grab your Fastpass. Remember, they're free! As soon as you grab it, note the show time and be there an entire hour early. Pick your viewing area and be in the front. Good, we're here, show is about to start. Why do you need this to be 3 episodes? Because you didn't do any of those things I just told you to do, did you? Nope, you spent all that time playing in the park, and now the show's about to start and you really want to watch it. Okay, there's barely hope for you. Like, you're probably not going to like this, but this is all I've got left. There are alternative viewing options if you did not get a Fastpass in advance like you were supposed to. However, they offer very, very poor views of the action that is going on, and space is extremely limited. The sound is pretty loud though, you'll be able to hear it just fine. Whether you're watching Fantasmic or World of Color, just ask the nearest cast member where your alternative viewing area is. Again, get there sooner than later. You're not the only slacker trying to watch the show at the absolute last minute, because once these spots fill up, that's it. I'm not making a 4th episode about this, because that is truly it. Squeeze in there, make new friends, do something, because this is your final chance to watch the show. But please, 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 please be aware that they are extremely mediocre viewing areas. If this is not your last day in the park, I would seriously consider holding off to watch the show another day. Trust me, check it out. There is the viewing area, nice, posh, specifically designed for viewing the shows unless you're Fantasmic who popped up way the heck later and plopped itself in Tom Sawyer Island and there's absolutely no room for you whatsoever, but hey, we work with what we've got. And then there is the walkway behind the viewing area. You see, even though there's a show going on, this is still a walkway. This isn't Disney World where they've got unlimited space to build an entire amphitheater for one show, and then behind that is an extremely busy walkway as your alternative viewing area. Tight, close in, not comfortable. Imagine standing there, and your line of view is everything else in the viewing area, an entire walkway full of people trying to get around, and the real viewing area, packed full of people, and then finally the show. You see where I'm going with this?
But Minnie!
What?
There's a nice trash can right there that I could sit on.
No. You don't sit on the trash can. That's unsanitary and unsafe. You should not, cannot sit on the trash cans.
How about this big pillar I can climb? Now I have a way better view than everyone else.
No, you're not Tarzan. You don't climb anything. Don't risk your life for one silly show.
How about all these nice spots in the walkway?
No, the walkway is not for viewing. You do not view the show in the walkway. You view the show in the viewing area. Believe me, there are endless cast members posted throughout the area to remind you of this. That is literally their only job during the show. You will not enjoy it if you try to view it anywhere that's not a viewing area.
But Manny, I can't even see the viewing area. There's some very tall people standing in front of me.
That's just really unfortunate. You should have arrived before them.
No, Manny, I'm just gonna tell the cast member to make them move.
No, no you're not. The cast member's not gonna make anyone move under any circumstance. This operation runs on a first-come, first-served basis. You said that yourself in the last episode.
But Manny, it's been a very long day, and I feel entitled to whatever I want.
But you're not entitled.
You know what, Manny? As a matter of fact, I'm getting quite tired of your bullshit. Week after week, I stand here and take crap from you, but not anymore. I'm taking over the show now, Manny. I'm taking over the show!
You know what? I can't even with you right now. Animator, can we get a new cartoon thing?
What? You can't get rid of me. I'm the star. I'm the one that makes the show. You're nothing without me, Manny. Nothing! Now be a good cast member and do what I say. As a guest, I'm the one that rents your paychecks, bitch. And things are about to change around here. What? What is that thing? Make it stop! Make it stop, Manny! No!
Hello?
Hey there, I'm Manny Luke. Congratulations on making it to the end of the episode. If you enjoyed it, then there's a lot more where that came from. Just go to MewNowTV.com and hit the freebie tab to see all the latest episodes from my show and all the other wonderful shows on the site. If you want even more, then become a secret agent. It's only $6 for one entire year, and you get full access to every episode of every show we've ever aired. That, and I Would Love You Forever. Follow me on Twitter, Instagram, and Snapchat for fun behind-the-scenes content, and I will catch you guys in the next episode. Goodbye!
Very weird. What happened? Where am I? Why do I look so different? What's going on here?